from OCTV.
Raider Nation's leading news magazine starts now. This is Current OC.
Hello and welcome to the Current OC. I'm Taylor Mulford.
And I am Rai Chowdhury. We are so excited to be here for our first show of the year.
It's been a busy start to the school year and we have lots to get to. So we start with the highlight of the fall, tradition of homecoming. Always a special time where alumni come home to see their school again, catch up with old friends, watch the football game, and see who is crowned homecoming queen. A great show by Raider Nation, a big turnout in the stands for the Pink Out. All eyes were on our two contestants vying for homecoming queen, Ginger Mullum and Noli Shank. And once they tally the votes, Noli takes the crown as your 2024 homecoming queen. Congratulations to Noli and her parents, as Dr. O'Neill presents her with the flowers and sash. That's a memory for a lifetime. Also, big shout out to Ginger for her OC spirit and leading the way with Raider Nation. Earlier in the day, everyone fired up for the first pep rally of the year. We have a packed house in the gym. The surf team set the tone with the best entrance. You know that surfer lingo? Grady Hoffman got pitted in the barrel. The skits and performances by the band cheerleaders and dance team were off the charts because that's how we roll at OC.
That's right, Taylor, but we can't talk about the pep rally without giving a shout out to the Spanish club for bringing the energy. Who knew the Jalapeno Bowl would be so fiery? Honestly, it's one of the most heated games I've ever seen. Let's take a bite of the highlights. It's getting hot in here. Students and staff participated in the first ever OC Jalapeno Bowl. Jalapenos were flying into contestants' mouths, emotions were high, and so was the heat. Mr. Tabano, who's tough as nails and eats tin cans according to Mr. Pezza, tapped out and bowed to the competition after the two-minute first round. Coming in as one of the favorites, senior Dom Cucci ultimately claimed the title of Jalapeno champ after defeating freshman Antonio Vieira in the final round. Dom hit his famous split, signed autographs, and posed for photos. Dom has hired an agent and is making celebrity appearances. You may see him in some future eating contests.
Wow, what a competition. You think you'd eat that many jalapenos?
I love spicy snacks, but I'd rather not eat more than, I'd say about five.
Yeah, no, spice is not for me. But our friend Dom Cucci, taking the win, insanely ate 23 jalapenos. Here is his after the big victory.
Ready? All right, Dom, how do you feel?
Good.
Good?
Good.
How was it? Did you feel like you had to throw up or anything?
I mean, not really.
Not really?
Maybe once, but that's about it.
Would you ever do it again?
Yeah.
Yeah?
I'd do it tomorrow.
All right, good job, Dom.
Yeah.
There you go. Woo!
Oh, yeah. I'm the winner. Dom Cucci right here. Dom Cucci right here.
That is a lot of jalapenos. Will there be a Jalapeno Bowl too? We'll have to wait and see on that. Now moving on, back in August, Ocean City Mayor Jay Gillen announced the closing of the amusement park.
Gillen's closed its doors this October, marking the end of an era. The long-standing tradition of families and friends visiting Gillen's during their trips to the Jersey Shore has come to a close. For many, it's sad to see it go. Here's our story on the closing of the Wonderland.
After a 94-year run, Gillian's Wonderland Pier just closed this past weekend. It marks the end of a tradition for local families and vacationers. For many, Gillian's holds nostalgic memories and good times. We spoke with students and staff of Ocean City to hear their thoughts on the closure.
My heart's breaking because I want to miss the sound of it, the watching the people, especially the children walk up the street.
I think it's really sad because I feel like everybody just has memories of going there when they were little with their families, and now it's kind of going to be ripped away for future generations.
Yeah, especially because it's like our last year of high school, and it's like,
yeah,
that's going away too, so it's just like
bittersweet.
Yeah.
Gillian's has been a big staple in Ocean City since I moved here in 1990. It's was one of my favorite things to do as a child, go up on the boardwalk and go down to the rides, and yeah, closing this year is pretty sad.
When I was a kid, I liked riding on the carousel. They used to have an arm that they would swing out with these rings inside it, and you would go around and try to grab the rings. So that was very exciting.
However, many hope that something from Gillian's can be saved.
I kind of would like to see some element of it still staying, perhaps a Ferris wheel or whatnot. But any type of food installation would be fantastic. Perhaps a donut factory. And then the Ferris wheel could be repurposed as a large donut.
Is something that's going to incorporate the Ferris wheel. We're going to save Ferris.
I'm Rye Chowdhury from the Current OC, signing off.
Ocean City won't be the same without the Wonderland Pier. I'm definitely sad to see it go. Makes you wonder what the future holds. And that's true for our new freshman class. Hopefully by now, they should be adjusted to their new surroundings. Recently, our Current OC cameras caught the freshmen in action as they hit the field for our annual team building event. Here's Madison Bayham with the story.
Hey, OC. Freshman Field Day is a highlight of the school year where students get together and bond with new people. Let's go check it out.
What's your name?
Leanne Rumler.
Alyssa McQuillan.
Camilla Yoder.
Who is your favorite upperclassman in the group?
You.
Cole DeCicino.
None.
So very excited to see the creation of some new beach sport by our very bright scholars, like this one here, our seniors here. They were throwing around hula hoops and catching them with sticks. That is high intellect activity, and I think they've invented a new game.
With so much happening on campus, our student athletes have been just as busy making moves on the field and court. From big wins to standout performances, we've got all the highlights.
That's right, Rye. Let's check in with Cameron to get a full rundown on the things in sports. Cameron, what's the latest?
Sports this month have been very exciting, to say the least, for the Red Raiders. The OC football team is playing with a chip on their shoulder and is looking to prove why they feel they're the best team in Group 3. Ocean City football sits at 5-3 after a heartbreaking loss to one of the top-ranked teams in New Jersey, Holy Spirit. The Red Raiders will face Cedar Creek in their last game of the regular season. Coach Kevin Smith's squad is looking to finish strong going into the playoffs. Ocean City will need to rely on key playmakers, J.P. Forrester, Tommy Grimley, Clifford Dirks, and Walker Bailey down the stretch to take the Group 3 title. And don't you forget about the dynamic duo, Tristan Schmidt and Clay Compton, who have complemented each other perfectly as one of the best 1-2 punches in South Jersey. It's been a dominating fall for our runners. The boys and girls cross-country teams took home Cal Championships this week. The boys with 1-2-3 finish thanks to Eric Pressner, Ethan Buck, and Keenan Newman. For the ladies, senior Maeve Smith, along with Chloe Kerr and Carly Godfrey, are among the top runners in the state. Also, girls soccer is 16-3, won the Cal Championship, and Naomi Nuehi leads the team with 25 goals. Here's our fall sports recap by Ryan Baldwin. Time now to turn to the Eagles. The Birds are getting set for a showdown with the Bengals. The Eagles are looking for their third straight win after a rocky start to the season. Recently, current OC football analyst J.P. Urban joined me to break down the Birds' start to the season.
Hey, OC, I'm JP Urban along with Cameron Williams, and it's been a rough opening month for the Philadelphia Eagles. After a promising start, they've hit a serious rough patch. What's going on with the Birds, Cam?
That's right, JP. The Eagles are currently facing a lot of challenges. Injuries have really impacted their performance, especially on the offensive line and key skill positions. It's been hard for the team to find really any consistency.
Yeah, the defense hasn't been much better. Missed tackles, blown coverages, and it's not the dominant unit fans were hoping for this season. How much of this is on the coaching staff?
Yeah, well, there's definitely some heat on head coach Nick Sirianni. Some questionable play calling in critical moments has fans frustrated, but it's also clear that the team just isn't executing, and that goes beyond the coaches.
Exactly. The season's far from over, and the Eagles do have a favorable schedule coming up. So can the Eagles turn things around?
They'll definitely need to regroup if they want to get a shot at making the playoffs, and it's going to take better execution, fewer mistakes, and hopefully players getting healthier soon.
We'll be watching closely. We wanted to see what the fans thought about the Eagles. Take a look as Cam and I head out to the school hallways to talk to Eagles fans about their early struggles.
Birds, Super Bowl. You heard it here first.
They have some problems they got to sort out, sort of like their coaching. Jalen Hurts needs to play up his game a little bit better, but they have a chance.
Run it! Run it!
They got the talent. They can turn this season around. It's not a lost cause. They had a lot of injuries last week. You know, the defense has got to shore some things up, but offensively, I think they can score on any team in the NFL. And, you know, I'm confident that they're going to bring it back and hopefully have a good end of the season. So, go Eagles.
Football, like throw a ball, catch a ball.
Yes, sir.
Get a touchdown.
Yes, sir.
Definitely some interesting takes from our Eagles fans. We'll see what happens over the next few weeks. That's going to do it for our look at the Birds.
Reminder to Raider Nation, we need you at Cedar Creek tonight for the football game. That's a look at sports. Back to you.
Well, that will do it for us on this edition of The Current OC.
Remember to log on and catch all our shows and additional content by visiting oc-tv.org.
We're also on social media, OCNJTV, so be sure to like our page and follow us there too.
Thanks for watching.